Welcome all to a new video, and today I will explain how to set up a MetaMask, connect your Ledger hardware wallet to it, and move Floki tokens to and from your hardware wallet. Let's get into it. There are timestamps in the video allowing you to skip chapters. I do recommend watching the whole video though, and it's also better for the algorithm. Before we start with the tutorial, I do want to stress that hardware wallets, and thus Ledger, offer the highest level of security. This is because of two purposes. One, they keep your private keys from the internet, which helps avoiding your assets being compromised in cyber attacks, phishing sites, and malware. This is why people also call it a cold wallet or cold storage. Two, they let you sign and confirm transactions on the blockchain. When you create a blockchain transaction, you're physically signing a special message. Your signature proves ownership of your private key. It's impossible to forge this signature without the key, so no one else can make a transaction on your behalf without it. Ledger is one of the most popular and used hardware wallets. It's a company based in France and has been around for about 5 years. They use some pretty advanced tech to keep your crypto secure, and there have been no known hacks on any Ledger devices so far. Only buy a Ledger device from their official website or official resellers. You can find these on their website, and I put a link in the description as well. On this page, you can select your country and find an official reseller. In this tutorial, I will assume that you already have your Ledger device unpacked it and installed. If not, you can pause this video and follow the link in the description explaining how to set up your Ledger device. Ledger offers an entry-level device called the Ledger Nano S for $79, and their flagship device is the Ledger Nano X for $149. The biggest difference between these two is the mobile support, as the Nano X is Bluetooth enabled. For this guide, it won't matter which version you use. I will showcase 4 steps. Step 1. Setting up MetaMask. Step 2. Connecting your Ledger to MetaMask. Step 3, transferring Floki to your Ledger. And step 4, transferring Floki from your Ledger. To set up a MetaMask, go to metamask.io. The website should recognize which browser you're using, and you can download the extension. In this case, we will use Microsoft Edge for a Windows PC. After the extension has been added to your browser, simply follow the steps to install. You can import an existing wallet or create a new wallet. Let's create a new wallet. After creating a password, you can watch a short video to learn about your secret recovery phrase and how to keep your wallet safe. Next, you will see your secret recovery phrase. Store these 12 words somewhere offline, safe, and never share them to anyone. In the last screen, you have to select each phrase in order to make sure it is correct. After confirming this, you are done. We now have an own MetaMask with an own wallet address. You may notice that by default, we only have the Ethereum mainnet added as network. If you want to use the Binance Smart Chain network, simply click Add Network and fill in the details provided on Binance, their official source. A link to the source can also be found in the description. After you have added the network, a confirmation will appear in the bottom right of the screen. Now we can connect the Ledger to our MetaMask. Click on your account on the top right and select Connect Hardware Wallet. Select the Ledger, plug in your device to your computer, and click Continue. A pop-up will appear where you can select your Ledger to connect to MetaMask. When you run into the following error, you have 4 options. The last option worked for me. I opened the Ethereum app, clicked both buttons simultaneously, and continued. You have 10 different hardware wallet addresses and can select an account to unlock. When you click on the 3 dots on the top right of the screen and go to Account Details, you can change the account name. Let's go with Ledger 10 Test. Now that we have set up a MetaMask and connected our Ledger hardware wallet to it, we can withdraw some Floki to it. Go to the exchange where you hold Floki and click on your spot account. From here, you can see your Floki tokens and click on Withdraw. It doesn't matter what exchange you use, the process is the same. From here, you have the option to withdraw from the Ethereum or Binance Smart Chain, depending on the availability. You may notice a higher bid draw fee for the Ethereum chain, so keep that in mind. Let's use the Binance Smart Chain. We will go to our MetaMask, make sure the chain is set to the Binance Smart Chain, and click on our hardware wallet. From here, we can copy the wallet address and go back to the exchange. There, we can pass the wallet address, choose how much Floki we want to withdraw, enter the security information, and confirm. Then, we can go back to MetaMask and click on Import Tokens. This is important to see the Floki. Simply paste the contract address and add the token to our wallet. You can find the contract addresses for the Ethereum and Binance Smart Chain on CoinMarketCap or in the description. A few moments later, we will see that the Floki has been received on the hardware wallet address. For the last part of this video, I will show you how to transfer Floki from your hardware wallet to another wallet address. We will transfer the tokens to our MetaMask wallet, but you can replace the wallet address with any other. Make sure you have some BNB on your wallet to cover any gas fees. Let's go to our MetaMask and copy the wallet address. Then we go back to our hardware wallet, click on Send Floki, and pass the MetaMask wallet address. We will select the amount again. In this case, we will withdraw everything and click Next. Make sure that you plug in your Ledger device and select the Ethereum app. Also, enable smart contract or blind signing. Then click on Confirm and you will see a request pop up on your Ledger device that you have to physically confirm. After you did this, the transaction is confirmed and sent to the wallet address. Let's go to our MetaMask and import the contract address there as well to see the Floki. We can see that the Floki has already been deposited on our MetaMask wallet. And that's it for today all. You now know how to set up a MetaMask, connect your Ledger device to it, and transfer Floki tokens in and out of your hardware wallet. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and consider subscribing. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below and I will answer these as soon as possible. See you all next time. Bye now.